Those of you who don't know me, my name is Brenda Snows. I'm going to tell my story, I guess. Back in 99, I was probably the most conservative person you'd ever see. I didn't believe in any of this stuff. I didn't believe. I did as a kid, but I didn't then. In 2000 and, well, in 99, I got divorced. I went through a whole letting everything go. I let my whole world go. My kids, jobs, everything gone. And I went through, so that's a rebirthing. And that's where I started, is that rebirthing. I had heel spurs. I went to a gal up in Blackhawk. She did quantum energetics. I floated out of there, decided I was going to learn how to do this. Went to Fort Collins to classes for 18 months, back and forth on weekends. Learned that. I have been through theta healing classes, cell and organ regeneration classes. I've worked with Drumville Melchizedek. Many more teachers out there. We all have teachers. Pay attention to them. They're pretty awesome. And so, fast story, here I am. I walk with Thoth, who is an Egyptian god, who stands about right here in my circle, my heart circle. In between him and me is a winged unicorn. That's my magic. Over on this side is a dragon. Dragons are okay. It's good. Metatron, who, I don't know, Metatron's the right hand of God. I don't know. Metatron to me is a huge blue angel, and he is awesome. Just lately, I have, well, about two days ago, I asked for healing physicians from the other side of the highest and best good, of the highest and best vibration. I now have three light beings that travel with me. And they're very new to me. So what I know of them, they work, they do the work. And I'm just a witness. When I work with people, I am a witness. And spirit comes in and does the healing. Spirit comes in and does the work. I witness what they are doing. That's what I am, is a witness. And I love it. And I argue with them all the time. I argue with spirit. And they win. Simple as that. I also channel a group called the Elders Three. They are three indigenous women from all over the world. And these three are amazing. They are upbeat. They want you to laugh. They don't want you to be so serious. They want you to be in the moment. And they're just an amazing group. I'm not real sure what's coming through today. It's not just the Elders Three. From what I understand, we're going to do some toning. What comes through in the toning is a lot of times it's angels. Sometimes it's beings that are here to help you release and let go of junk that isn't yours. We all have so much stuff that's not ours. You can't even wake up in the morning without getting something that's not yours. You're taking it from a spouse. You're taking it from somewhere. Be aware of that so that you're not taking on somebody else's junk. Clean and clear yourself. Get rid of it. So the first part of it is toning. I'm sure that it is a release soul to let go of your junk. Try to just be in the moment. Try not to think of anything. Try not to say, okay, I want to get rid of this. Just let it go. You don't have to think or anything. Just enjoy. Anything that goes on here that you are just going, no, that's okay. If it's not your thing, if it bothers you in any way, just say no. It won't happen. Free will. We are on a free will planet. We are on a free will planet that is no more secrets. If you see the news, there are no more secrets. Check out your own life. You know, no more secrets, which is a good thing. So have fun with that. And here we go.
Picture yourself standing on your favorite spot in nature, that special place that you are in the most in love with Gaia, the spirit of Mother Earth. And as you are sending your love to Gaia, we're going to take a deep breath in from the earth and bring that energy of Gaia up into our feet. Just allowing it to slowly come up our legs. This unconditional healing loving energy will just allow it to permeate every cell of our body and in between every cell of our body as we bring it up to our knees, up to the thighs, the hips and the stomach, and bringing this energy up into your chest and allowing it to flow down your arms. And again, just breathing this energy all the way up to the top of your head. The second breath, we're going to breathe in from Source, Creator, God, whatever it is that you call the higher power. We're going to bring this energy from Source. We're going to bring it down into and through our local sun, where we pick up crystalline energies for our physical body. And we just bring this energy from Source, Sun, Soul, down into your crown, and just breathe in this unconditional healing, loving energy into your body. Just allowing it to flow through every cell of your body and in between every cell of your body as we bring it down to your chest. Allowing it to permeate all through your body, clear down to the tip of your toes. The third breath is where we bring the energy from both earth and from sky, both together, both from Source, Sun, Soul, and from Gaia. And as we breathe in this third breath, we're going to bring the energy of earth and sky into your chest. And that's going to swirl and twirl together with you. That is the Trinity, earth, sky, and you. Next, we're going to visualize our consciousness as that little ball of light that sits right behind our pineal gland, right in the middle of our brain. So as we take in another breath from both earth and sky, when we release that breath, we're going to drop straight down to the throat and then straight down into the sacred space of the heart. So let's take in that deep breath from both earth and sky, mixing those two together with you. And as we release that breath, drop your consciousness right down to your throat and then down straight into the sacred space of the heart. And just settle into the heart.
So if I take a deep breath in and relax, and just close your eyes and just be. Just be. And we fill this room of all the goodness and all the greatness. Just fill it. Feels the room. Each and every one of you are connected. Each and every one of you. You're connected with the ones who walk with you, connected with the ones who walk with those who walk with you. And you're connected with each other. There's some great power running through here. Can you feel it? And just relax. Everybody take a deep breath in. Real deep, 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 and blow. Try that again. Deep, 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 deep breath. And then blow everything out. And once more, the deepest breath as you can get. And blow it out. And come back into this room. Are we feeling lighter and brighter yet? There was a lot of wind. I hope everybody had good breath. So that was as easy as that. Clearing and cleaning out these energies that are no longer yours. You're going through the day and you think you get a hold of an energy that's not yours. All of a sudden you're sad. And it's... you have no reason to be sad. Just think about that sadness and go, you're not mine. Clean it. And cleaning it is just saying, you're not mine. Get rid of it. Another tool you can use is run a tornado on yourself. Imagine a tornado of any color that you prefer. Imagine that tornado coming up from your feet and going all the way up to above your head, pulling out all this energy that's not yours. So keep an eye on things that are not yours. Pain. If you get a pain where there's no reason for you to have that pain there, get rid of it. It's not yours. Just ask it to go away. Not your pain. So there's no reason for you to have it. You don't need to take on anybody else's pain. That'd be silly. The other thing is, I got lost. What is the other thing? Tornadoes.
It's hard to remember the time. Silly.
Well, it was silly. The elders popped in going, it's silly. And now I got lost.
Huh? The whole idea, when we're learning to let go, we're emptying spaces inside of ourselves. And I was so overjoyed when somebody said, okay, now fill it up with something you like. And fill it up with something happy or something you need.
And that's the next step. You get ahead of me. So we just went through the letting go process. So you've got empty space within you. And now we're going to fill it up. And we're going to fill it up with unconditional love. We're going to fill it up with joy, with happiness, with laughter. Those are the keys to life. Joy. Joy in everything. Joy in a sickness. Sorry. What is that sickness teaching you? There's something there. What is it teaching you? Fill it with unconditional love. Fill it with joy. Fill it with laughter. Those are the keys to healing. Those are the keys to move you forward. And just be. Just be. Quit worrying about the bills tomorrow. Just be. Okay. So here we go. This time, detoning's going to be to fill you up. And this to fill you up with what you want. Fill yourself up with joy, with unconditional love, with whatever the soul's going to bring down to you. And here again, try not to direct, just be. Just let it happen. Your soul, for each and every one of you, is here. Your soul is right there orchestrating what's going on. So just allow. Allow your soul to be in charge just for 5 minutes. Okay, here we go. Everybody take a deep breath in and out. And then just take a nice, easy breath in and out. Bringing yourself back into center. Another breath and out. How are we doing now? Everybody okay? All right. So you got rid of your old junk? You brought in new stuff? We're not gonna call it junk. Brought in new stuff. And go from there. Try not to fall back into patterns that you know are not good for you. Be aware of your body. Each and every one of you are great creators. You're great creators of your life. So let's create something different with your life if you don't like what it is. If you love the way it is, keep going. You're doing good. As a great creator, love your body. Love what it is. Love every part of it. And that is really a hard thing to do, let me tell you. I worked at it for a long time. And as soon as I could absolutely love my body, could love who I am within it, things started happening. Things started moving and shaking. And here we are, trying to get everybody else to move and shake. Okay. I think we got elders knocking at the door. Alrighty. And we are the elders three. How are you all? Miss Mary is wonderful, as usual. We are here to brighten your day. We are here to tell you, no, life's good. It truly, truly is. There's lots and lots of chaos out there. You can turn on that news and you can find it. You can look around yourself and you can find it. You can look in your families and you can find it. There's chaos everywhere. It's part of the change. This whole world is changing. Your lives are changing. Your bodies are changing. Your souls are changing. It's a constant change. Are you going to keep up? That would be the question. So you need going with the flow. Trying to stay out of chaos. Let the chaos happen. That is part of the change. People have to go through chaos to find their change, to find who they are. In the chaos, they can go, I don't want this. Any of you listen to Abraham Hicks? If you go through and you are in great chaos and you don't like it, then you know what you want. What do you want? That's another question that sometimes is really hard to answer. I don't want this, but I really don't know what I want. Try the best that you can to figure out what you want. Figure out a path that you want to travel. And you find yourself going down this path, and you get down here, and you go, oh, I don't like this. That's okay. Get over to this path. Try that. This world is made for you to make mistakes in. It is okay. Make those mistakes. They are good. That's how you learn. That's how you become, is through your mistakes. So then, you find a path that you just love, and you're traveling down this path. Be willing to change with the path. Be willing to change directions. Try not to be, this is the way it's gonna be. You must go with the flow. Imagine yourself as water. You see how water goes down a river? It just flows around things. Try to flow down the river. Try to flow around those problems or meet them head on. Don't turn around and run from them. Don't turn around and be scared of them back there. Face them. Face your problems. Look at them. Head on, look at them. Not look at them like this, because then you get fear. Look at them straight on. Straight on. They might not be as bad as you think it was. And when you look at them straight on, you can see the solution. It's there. Just gotta find it. And laughter. Where is your laughter? Mr. Mike. Is it out in the car? It's a good thing you left Zeus in the car. He is your laughter. Find your laughter. Find your joy. Find joy in things that is boring. Find some joy in it if you have to do it. Give it gratitude. Give it appreciation. We teach the heart-to-heart with the infinity symbol. before we ever started this workshop, we connected with each and every one of you through the heart. And then as you were going, you each connected each and every one of you through the heart. And even the ones watching. Everybody's connected through the heart. This place is filled. Can you feel it? It is so filled. And so that is one of the tools that we give you, is the infinity, heart to heart, especially people you don't like. Because there you can see the difference. When you do heart to heart with a loved one, it is very great. But when you do heart to heart with somebody that you are having problems with, your attitude changes, their attitude changes, and you can move on. It's very cool. Something you should try. And so we are here on the solstice. And we are here on this new moon. You just went through a releasal of letting go of all that junk. You just went through bringing in all the unconditional love, bringing in these great and grand downloads from your soul. And you are just about ready, if you choose, to go through another download. These downloads come through your head. They're going to come through the toning in the bowl. And they go into your heart. And there they are met with an upload. An upload is from your DNA. It is a remembering. It is a remembering of who you are. It is a remembering of your being a great and powerful creator. It is a remembering of the gratitude you have for this life, the joy you have for this life, is remembering that you really did want to be here. It is just great fun. And so we are going to step back again. We thank each and every one of you for being here. We thank each and every one of you for your love, for your joy, for your laughter, for your presence. Each and every one of you are changing the world. By every person you touch in this world, you have changed the world. By every smile you have given to somebody else, you've changed the world. You have lots of responsibility on your shoulders. Now laugh. Thank you. It is our honor. Okay, and we're back. Yes, ma'am.
When you first did the elders three, they were, you know, like a cathedral organ call.
Right?
Now, they're not. Mm-mm. They're just here.
They're here. The elders three have incorporated with me so much that it's like I am the elders three. Okay. Or the elders three are, however that works. But in the beginning, they were huge, and they felt so huge. And they still feel huge to me when they come in. I can still feel that great, it's just like, wow. And then they take off, and they have so much fun. And I get to kind of stand back here in the background listening to them. And I guess it's more than that, because it's almost like they do these drops information or whatever they do. So it's great fun. And I like listening to that last video that we did when I got to actually hear what they were saying. I was like, oh, that's cool. So it was fun. So anyway, they're talking about doing downloads. There's been a presence with me since, so probably last night sometime. And that presence had his hand on my left shoulder most of the night. And as things were gathering in here earlier, he came into my heart, and it was like you could just feel him. He's huge, this presence that wants to do with you, bringing in downloads. And you don't have to accept this. If you don't want it, you know, just say no in your mind. No, thanks. But if you want them, just say yes. Just be present. Let them come in. Sounds like they kind of changed the DNA, which is a good thing. It's the changes that are going on in the earth. The earth is constantly changing. And we are constantly having to keep up with it. And so it's just one of those things to help make it a little easier. Help make your life a little easier in this new world. Download, Terry.
There's a word on the computer. You say download.
And an upload. Don't forget the upload. The upload that is within you, because everything that you need is within you. You already have it. All this download is coming down into you and reminding your body, reminding you who you are, reminding you of your gifts that you have, reminding you that you can heal yourself. You can give great pleasure and gratitude to people around you to help them through their life also. So it's just a remembering. All it is. And here we go. So everybody take a deep breath in. And out. And another deep breath in. And out. And one more. Deep breath in and out. And try not to guide this. Try not to move it. Just allow. Just relax. Let your soul is here taking care of you. Your soul is the one doing the work. So allow your soul to do what your soul does. Gratitude and appreciation, you raise the vibrations of your body and all your bodies. Take a deep breath in. Imagine running energy as you breathe out into the earth. Breathe into the earth. Take another deep breath in. Breathe into the earth again, blowing all the energy into the earth. Once more, deep breath in. And breathe into the earth. You just grounded the energy that just comes through your body into the earth. Grounded it into your body and into the earth. And please give a great gratitude and appreciation to the earth and to your soul and to all those that are here that have walked with us through this solstice, new moon, awakening. And come back as you get there, as you feel you're complete. Deep breath in again, bring the energy from the earth up through your body and release. Another deep breath in, bringing the energy from soul, sky, sun down into your body and release. One more deep breath. Mix the energy of the earth, the energy of sky in your body, around and around and around, and breathe out. Great and powerful beings, each and every one of you. Make sure you're grounding yourself. You've been in a state of meditation for a while here. Don't be driving. Everybody, make sure they are drinking a lot of water after this. Your body's going to need water to move the energy. Any questions? Are we all doing good? Okay. And I think we are complete. And just give yourselves a moment here to just be. All righty.